Deer Trail, Colorado, population 598. A small town with big American pride, claiming to be home of the world's first rodeo.
This is David and Goliath.
Deer Trail resident Philip Steele is ready to fight for Old West values that he believes are threatened by drones.
So if you see one overhead, what are you proposing to do?
I am proposing to shoot it down.
Steele says it was the National Defense Authorization Act that got him fired up. He read about the government's plan to add 6 bases for drone testing and invest $23 billion into new unmanned aerial vehicles. The FAA says thousands of drones could be flying over our heads by 2020.
The idea of eyes in the sky, Steele says, is just not the American way. His message to the government, not in my backyard.
So Steele drafted a drone hunting ordinance that goes up for a town vote tomorrow. A yes vote would give licensed residents in this 1 square mile town the go-ahead to shoot down a drone that comes within 1,000 feet of their homes.
But you don't want people to take this seriously.
Well, of course I want them to take it seriously.
Steele insists he's thought of everything. The ordinance specifies the kinds of weapons and ammunition you can use and even puts a bounty on recovered drone parts. $25 for the fuselage or wing, $100 for a whole drone that has U.S. government markings.
Well, that's a federal offense to destroy government property on top of that, and it's a ridiculous thing and embarrassing the town.
Despite opposition, Steele's idea has found support.
I would shoot a drone down if it's peering in my window, scanning me, and it's within elevation where I can nail it.
Former Deer Trail Mayor Robert Copley is one of some 400 people who've already purchased Steele's novelty drone hunting licenses just to make a statement.
People are buying them because they believe in the cause and they want to display these. Also, they're very beautiful.
They're printed on vellum, stamped with the logo that says, "Kill them all, death from below."
It says license may not be recognized by tyrannical municipal, state, or federal governments.
The FAA is keeping an eye on Deer Trail's special election and issued a statement that warns shooting an unmanned aircraft could result in criminal or civil liability, just as would firing at a manned airplane. All of this setting up a possible legal duel between the local and federal governments.
There are many things that are illegal. The U.S. federal government declared war on us. This is our response.
Steele insists he won't be deterred from shooting at a drone, but hopes the ordinance would deter drones from passing through Deer Trail. For Out Front, Anna Cabrera, Deer Trail, Colorado.